In this video, I will be showing you how to connect the SolarWinds Service Desk with Microsoft Azure for single sign-on. The approximate configuration time will be about 30 minutes. To start the process, we will log into your Azure portal. And from within Azure, we will be going to the Enterprise Applications. So to get there, I'm going to click on Azure Active Directory. Then in the left-hand pane, I will be clicking on Enterprise Applications. Now, once I've got the list of enterprise applications, I will be clicking New Application at the top, and I will be searching for SolarWinds Service Desk. You'll be clicking on the first icon, which literally says SolarWinds Service Desk, not the SolarWinds Orion. Once you've clicked on it, you will then click Create in the lower bottom corner of it, and it will add the application. Once it's done adding the application, it will open up the app for you. So once the enterprise application has been added, the first thing that we'll do is we'll click on Properties under the Manage section. In this section, we'll be going down towards the bottom and we'll be clicking where it says User Assignment Required. We will be switching this from Yes to No. This will allow all users within your Active Directory to authenticate through the single sign-on with Azure. Just be sure to hit Save at the top so that we keep those changes. Once you've clicked Save, the next thing that we're going to do is we'll click on Single Sign-On again in the left-hand pane. Once we've got this open up, we'll click on SAML. And this is where we'll start our configuration. The first step is we'll click Edit in step one for the basic SAML configuration. And the first thing that we're going to do is change our identifier. We're going to select everything, and we're going to replace that with SolarWinds.com. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to add a couple of reply URLs. And we'll need to add two different URLs here. And to do that, we're going to need to find our customer name. Our customer name is going to be your SolarWinds Service Desk subdomain for your account, also known as your account name. And to do that, we'll jump over into our SolarWinds account so we can find that. So once you have your SolarWinds Service Desk instance open, to find our account name, we're going to go to the Setup menu. From within the Setup menu, we're going to click on Account, and then we'll click on Account Summary. Your account name is going to be the first part of the account URL that is listed on your screen. So this is going to be SolarWinds Marketing for this particular instance. Now that we have that, we can take that back over into Azure and we can fill out our URLs. So now that we have our account name, the first URL that we're going to be adding is going to be https://app.samanage.com/saml/ our account name. For the second URL, we're going to copy the first one and we're going to paste that into the second box and we're going to replace the word app with our account name again. And those are the two basic URLs that we will need. Now, as a caveat, you may potentially need a third URL, and that will be determined if you are using the domain mapping feature in SolarWinds Service Desk. If you are using the domain mapping feature in SolarWinds Service Desk, you will replace the first part of the URL, so in this case, SolarWindsMarketing.SolarWinds.com, with the custom domain that you are using within the SolarWinds Service Desk. And that will be your third URL. Now that we've entered both of our reply URLs, the last thing that we need to do in the basic SAML configuration is enter our sign-on URL. To get our sign-on URL, we are again going to go back to our instance of SolarWinds Service Desk, and we will copy it from there. So now that we are back in the SolarWinds Service Desk, to find our login URL, we are going to go to Single Sign-On. From here, we are going to click on Azure AD. And we are going to copy the login URL listed on our screen. And so we'll just click that copy button. And now that we have that, we can go back to our instance of Azure. So now that we're back in Azure, we will just copy that sign-on URL into the box. And the last thing that we'll need to do here is hit save at the very top. Once we've hit saved, it'll test and give us a green check mark, and then we can move forward. So now that we've finished step one of the basic SAML configuration, the next thing that we will need to do is move down to step three, And within step three, what we're going to do is click the download button for the base 64 certificate. When you download this, you will want to make sure that you keep the file instead of opening it right away. With that downloaded, we'll be using that in the SolarWinds Service Desk configuration once we move back over to that side of the configuration. The last thing that we need to do here in Azure is move down to step four, and we're going to copy the login URL, which we will need for the SolarWinds Service Desk side of the configuration. So now that we've copied our login URL, we can actually switch back over to the SolarWinds Service Desk and finish our configuration there. Now that we are back in SolarWinds Service Desk, we're going to paste our Azure login URL into the Azure login URL box. The next thing that we're going to do is move down to the Azure identifier field, and we're going to type in SolarWinds.com. And it needs to match exactly how we entered it into the identifier that we have in Azure. Now that we've entered our Azure identifier, the next step will be to enter our certificate. So to get our certificate, we're going to take the base64 file that we just downloaded, and we are going to open that in a text editor. So once we've opened our file, we're just going to copy the entire contents of that, and we'll use that in our service desk configuration. So once you've copied the certificate, we're going to paste that certificate into the certificate box. And the next thing that we have are two checkboxes below that field. The first checkbox that we have is create users if they do not exist. What this option will be doing is if a user logs into Azure and authenticates successfully against your Active Directory, but they are not a user in the SolarWinds Service Desk, it will create them as a requester in the SolarWinds Service Desk with just their email address, allowing them to log in to the portal and submit their issue. The second checkbox that we have is an automatic redirect. It says redirect to the SAML login page when logging into SolarWinds Service Desk by default. What this will do is when you navigate to your URL for the SolarWinds Service Desk, it is automatically going to redirect to Azure for authentication. Once you've successfully authenticated with Azure, it will then take you back into the SolarWinds Service Desk based upon your user role. For testing purposes, while we're still configuring, I would recommend unchecking that box until you have verified that the configuration is accurate and successful. Once you've got all the configuration done, the last step here will be to click Update. And then you're now ready to test whether the single sign-on is working successfully. To do that, I would recommend opening up an incognito window or a private browsing session, depending on your browser, and then entering in your account URL and testing the login for Azure. Once you've successfully tested the single sign-on configuration, then I would recommend coming back here, checking the box for the redirect, and also checking the box to create users if you want that option available for you. And then finally hit update, and your single sign-on configuration is now complete.